Good morning, dear students. Now I am showing you one activity which is based on the equilibrium reaction. Concept of equilibrium, right? Equilibrium set up between two concentrations of reactants and concentration of product, right? And what is the mathematical expression for equilibrium? For reaction quotient or equilibrium constant? Equilibrium constant Kc is equal to product concentration upon reactant concentration, right? When value of Kc is equal to Qc, Qc is a reaction quotient, that state is called equilibrium state, right? P denotes product and this square bracket molar concentration, R reactant and square bracket molar concentration of reactants, right? Here is the study of equilibrium between different ions, ferric ion, thiocyanate ion and complex of iron and thiocyanate which appears in deep red color. Original color of any ferric salt like ferric chloride is light yellow in color, right? What is light yellow color? This is ferric chloride. Second is potassium thiocyanate. Potassium thiocyanate is colorless. Okay children, what happens when reaction occurs between ferric salt and potassium thiocyanate? Then first of all observe this sample, what happens after reaction between two chemicals. First of all I am taking ferric salt, ferric chloride. Then potassium thiocyanate. According to this expression, ferric salt is light yellow in color, pale yellow, right? And thiocyanate is colorless. This one is colorless, right? Reaction between two. Then what happens? Deep red color. Blood red color solution which is complex of iron. What is deep red? Right, this is dark red color like blood. And what is the name of this complex? What is thiocyanate-ferric 3-iron or complex of iron? Any complex is written in square bracket, right? Here metal is iron and ligand means anion which is attached with iron is a thiocyanate. Thio denotes sulfur, cyanate CN group, right? Here charge on iron is plus 3 and on thiocyanate is minus 1, right? Then plus 3 minus 1 is equal to plus 2, right? What is unneutralized charge in this complex? Plus 2, which is always shown, always written outside this is one bracket. Okay children, now first step is preparation of complex compound and second step is the study of effect of change in concentration, right? Now this is a stock solution of complex. Then children, I am taking equal amount of this red color complex in 4 different test tubes. Now children, first step is experiment and second step is further process, right? First test tube acts as reference This solution acts as reference solution for comparison of other samples in different conditions. Right? Now, this is test tube B. This is test tube A as reference sample. This is test tube B, second test tube. Now, addition of one reactant which is ferric chloride in this complex. Now children, according to Lee Chatelier's principle, increasing concentration of reactant always increases the amount of product. Right? Observe it carefully. This is blood red solution. Blood color red. In third test tube, addition of certain reactant which is potassium thiocyanate, colorless solution. Again, compare this sample with excess of potassium thiocyanate, and this is reference. What happens? Color intensity increases, right? Because this reactant concentration, increasing reactant concentration increases the amount of product. Now, in fourth sample, addition of third reactant, third chemical, right, which is not shown in this equilibrium reaction. And third compound is compound of potassium, potassium chloride. Now children, addition of KCl, aqueous solution of KCl, then what happens? Color intensity decreases, right? Comparison of this new color with color of reference sample, right? Which two concentrations increase the rate of forward reaction? First concentration is ferric ion and second is thiosulfate or thiocyanate ion. It means ferric chloride solution and potassium thiocyanate solution. These two concentrations or reactants support forward reaction. Support forward reaction where concentration or color intensity of complex solution increases. Right? But third one, which is KCl. KCl does not. What is the reason? KCl concentration does not support the forward. KCl concentration supports backward reaction. What is the reason? Answer is based on this reaction equation. KSCl. Source of this anion is this equilibrium between ions. This is molecule, ionic form of this reactant. When KCl is added, KCl is a strong electrolyte, then complete dissociation occurs. Complete dissociation occurs. Right? Excess of potassium ions supports which direction of this equilibrium? Backward. And what happens in backward direction? Formation of potassium thiocyanate. Right? Not formation of this complex. Only this complex is in which color? Deep red color. According to which principle? Lee Chatelier's principle. According to Lee Chatelier's principle. Okay children, according to Lee Chatelier's principle, in equilibrium state, right, when any concentration changes, any concentration, any means reactant concentration or product concentration, then equilibrium shifts in such direction or in that direction which minimizes the effect of change, minimizes the effect of change. Increasing concentration of KCl supports backward reaction or shifts equilibrium in the backward direction, but increasing concentration of reactants always supports forward direction or always supports the amount of product. And this product is colored, which appears in deep red color. Okay, children. So this is a study of Lee Tannenberg's principle on which type of reaction on equilibrium. Right. So this is the equilibrium between two. Okay, children. Now next one. Next activity based on nature of salts. Some salts are acidic. Some salts are basic. And some are neutral, right? For this analysis, of different types of salts, acidic salt, basic salt, neutral salt, either pH meter or pH paper, right? Then what happens? Single strip, single pH paper shows different shapes. For example, this is capillary tube, fine glass tube. Then what happens? On putting single drop of this on pH paper, then observe its color. Pink shade, this FeCl3 is acidic salt. Color is pink, right? Now second is, the first observe, this is colorless solution of one salt, right? Analysis of nature of this salt, right? Either this is basic, neutral or acidic. What happens? Blue shade. Blue shade indicates basic nature of salt, right? And third type is neutral. Third type salt is neutral, right? An effect of neutral salt on same strip, same pH paper. Shades are different. Different shades of different solutions, right? And this is pH indicator. This indicator indicates different pH values, right? Pink shade for acidic behavior, blue bottommost for basic, and light green where value 7.0 or maybe 6.9 or 7.223, like this. This is neutral behavior. This is pH indicator. Okay, children. In this way, we can compare, we can analyze pH behavior of any solution. Okay.